This morning our lesson is taken from Matthew. Our lesson is about John the Baptist. And it's amazing when we read and we think about John the Baptist, one of the things I've never put together is John the Baptist came first in everything in Jesus' life. John the Baptist was born before Jesus Christ. John the Baptist was in ministry before Jesus Christ. And John the Baptist also died before Jesus Christ. God had picked him from the beginning, before the creation of the world, and he sent him out into the desert to precede Christ. He was a forerunner of Jesus Christ to acknowledge to the world that there was one that was coming. So prepare the way of the Lord. Our gospel reading. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. For this is he who was spoken by the prophet Isaiah, saying, a voice crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight." Now John himself was clothed in camel's hair and a leather belt around his waist. And his food was locusts and wild honey. Then Jerusalem and all of Judea and all the region around the Jordan went out to him and were baptized by him in the Jordan, confessing their sins. But when he saw the many Pharisees and the Sadducees coming for his baptism, he said to them, "Brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Therefore bear fruits worthy of repentance. And do not think to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our father.' For I say to you that God is able to raise up the children of Abraham from these stones. And even now the axe is laid at the root of the tree. Therefore every tree which does not bear fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance, but he who is coming after me is mightier than I am, whose sandal I am not worthy to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire, with his winnowing fan in his hand, and he will thoroughly clean out the threshing floor and gather the wheat into the barn, and he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire." Then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. And John tried to prevent him, saying, "I need to be baptized by you, and you are coming to me." But Jesus answered and said to him, "Permit it to be so now, for thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness." Then he allowed him. And when he had been baptized, Jesus came up immediately from the water, and behold, the heavens were opened to him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting upon him. And suddenly, a voice came from the heaven saying, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you have brought Jesus Christ to us. You have set him as an example as to how we are to live our lives. He came and was baptized by man, and yet he was the Son of God. Oh Lord, make our baptism again real to us. For many of us do not even remember our baptism. But may we this day sense how important the baptism is that is created here in John the Baptist. For this we thank you, Lord. In your holy name we pray. Amen. John the Baptist, a man that walked out in the wilderness, that lived in the wilderness. His diet was honey and locusts. And God sent him to the Jordan River and through Galilee and all the way through to go out and talk to people that knew nothing about baptism. The only thing they knew about baptism was they would only baptize people that wanted to be converted to Judaism. A Jew was never baptized, ever, ever. And here they are, the common, ordinary man. They are listening to John the Baptist, and he's telling them to repent. He's telling them to look within them and see what their sin is and what they are keeping away from God. And that was his whole message, was repentance and turn to the Lord God. And as he shared, people are coming in hordes. His name gets spread all over the land of Judea, that John the Baptist is gathering people around him to baptize them. To baptize them. To anoint them. To tell them to repent, to go down and come back up again and be washed away and clean and holy. The Jews knew about sin. The Jews made many sacrifices to sin. They would go in on special days, and they would bring a sacrifice with them, and their sin would be taken away, and a goat that would leave Jerusalem and go out into the wilderness. And that's how their sin was taken away. But the sins here of the Pharisees and the Sadducees did not believe they needed to repent at all. They did nothing wrong. There was no way, because they were the children of Abraham, they were going to be in heaven one way or the other, no matter what they did. Because they were the children of Abraham. They could do anything. And what does John call them? He calls them a brood of vipers. Because they don't really know God. They know about Abraham, and that's their banner of honor. We are the children of Abraham, but there's no place in the scriptures that it says Abraham will save us. None. But the Jews totally believe that. And so John the Baptist is coming in and he's changing their whole world around. No, it doesn't work that way. But if we look at our world, we have the same thoughts and the same theory. After all, God is love. God is love. He can't possibly send me to hell, even though I'm an evil and a wicked person and I do whatever I want and I'm selfish. He cannot possibly send me to hell because he is love. He has to love me. It doesn't work that way. And John the Baptist is telling them that. It doesn't work that way. I am out here to tell you to repent, to turn your life around, to turn it and give it to God. Repentance is a huge, huge word. It's easier us to see where other people should repent, but it's hard for us to see within ourselves where we are to repent. There are times in our own lives, our own hearts, that we have set unforgiveness in our hearts and in our souls. We are mad at somebody. They have done something wrong to us. And sometimes that sin can be in there for 50 years. And we never even acknowledge that it's a sin. We never even look at it. Because we look and we say, well, they hurt me, so I can be mad at them. And John is saying, look within you. See what that does to your own heart. It's not them you are punishing. It truly is you. You are punishing your own self over and over again by remembering. And he said, that is sin. It is sin that you are holding captive. And so come and be baptized. Wash it away, repent of it, and let it go. Let it be washed away as the water washes over you. Let the sin also go in your life and start out brand new. But he says to them, as in the scripture of old, there is one that is coming that is greater than I am. That is greater than I am. I am not even worthy to carry the sandals. The one that carried the sandals was the servant. And he is telling us he's not even worthy to be the servant of Jesus Christ. He knows where he is, but he also knows who Jesus Christ is. I am not worthy. But here he sees the one that is coming towards him. He stands in the Jordan River. He looks out. He draws his breath. Wow. He's coming here. Jesus is really coming here to watch all the people that are here that come in and in repentance and to be baptized here. He must take his breath away. And John looks, and Jesus comes, and he doesn't stand out with the people around about. He enters into the water. He walks right up to John. And he said, I want you to baptize me. And John says, no, Lord, you should be baptizing me. You should be the one that is washing my sins away. And Jesus says, it must be so. It must be so. So John takes the Lord in his hands. He puts him down into the water. I baptize you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. He is baptizing the Son. Think about that. He is baptizing the Lord Jesus Christ. He comes up out of the water, and a dove appears. And the dove that we look at represents the Holy Spirit, is there with. Jesus is there. The symbol of the Holy Spirit is there. And then there's one more that is there watching all of this take place, didn't miss a drop, didn't miss a moment, didn't miss anything. And that was God himself. And the voice that comes down from heaven, this is my beloved in whom I am well pleased. The Father to the Son. I have no idea how many heard it. I have no idea how many seen the Son or seen the Holy Spirit. But it did make a difference. The words here tell us they were all there present that day. John came to tell us, turn our hearts around to the one that came into the water. He didn't need to be baptized. He was already holy and righteous. But he came to be baptized as an example for us that we need to be washed with the water of repentance. In our hearts, we need to let go of all the things that we hang on to us that make us miserable. Jesus Christ has something new. He has something different to give us. Number one, he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. Wow. We know so little about the Holy Spirit. We don't realize that everything we do and everything that God directs us to is directed by the Holy Spirit. If you get a thought in your mind that you need to pray somebody for somebody, believe it, that's not your heart telling you to do that. It is not. It is the Holy Spirit telling you to do that. You need to know that. It is so important because if you believe in your heart that is the Holy Spirit telling me to pray for a person, then you'll pray for them. But if you think alone that is just in your mind and it's no big deal, then you won't. And they will miss somebody that the Holy Spirit has been calling. Sometimes in our Christian walk, in our Christian faith, we do not know, and we keep saying to ourselves, I don't know what God wants, and I know what God wants. But we have been told to do what God wants. The only problem we have with it is we don't believe it. John the Baptist went to the Jordan River because God sent him there. Did he know that he was going to baptize Jesus Christ? No, he did not. Because you can tell by the surprise of him being there. I am not worthy to baptize you. It is by the Holy Spirit that John the Baptist was there. It was by the Holy Spirit that Christ was there to be baptized and that God was there. He wants to interfere in our lives, and how can he baptize us with fire when we don't believe? We need to repent in our hearts. We need to turn them back to God over and over again, because let's face it, we're human beings. We are human beings that fall a lot. But there's no way that God will not forgive us if our hearts are truly set on repentance. If our hearts are truly set on following the Lord Jesus Christ. Because with repentance comes following, comes the blessing, comes the member of the family of God. God has called us, each and every one. And today we have a special baptism going on. It is amazing, and I'll tell you my opinion. You most probably will disagree with it. But I do not believe that children should be baptized as infants. I believe that baptism is for you to do that when you're adult, so you make a confession of faith before the body of Christ that you are now a member of the family of God. They never had baptism until John the Baptist came. Never. Now we have baptism. And we do it as infants. And an infant, I will do an infant baptism. Don't get me wrong, I will really do that. But I believe that someplace you have to claim it in front of the body of Christ as an adult. And Haley and Alyssa and Jeanette are being our blessings today, because they are telling us they are accepting Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior and want to be baptized before the body of Christ. Today we celebrate with them and we rejoice with them. They are in the family of God. Let us pray.